I have 19. Well, we can at least try and turn this 19 into. I have no idea where we are in the harvesting process. Should wait till that happens. This just changed, so maybe soon? Otherwise, we'll get cobble. Don't need cobble. I mean, okay, we could use cobble. There we go. Go, go, go. Two of those. The mana spreader. We were gonna make the... Oh, this one just needs to be a pulse. We have one of those. We do need to make a phantom lens, and that is the one with the abstruse platform. Do I happen to have one? Hey, I have an open crate. No, that is with regular living wood and a bunch of the decorative. Remind me how to make those again. We need two of the framed and one patterned. Right. Oh, that's right. We need a mana pearl. Alright, this will be a test, since this has been just running for us for a little while. The last time I looked, I had 19 ender pearls, so 16 and 3. Let's see where it's at. 16 and 12! Yay! It might be about time to disable the other one. Maybe, maybe. Oh, it gives us two. I forgot about that. Okay, so now we just need to make a mana lens. Have a lens already? No. And glass. My hope for glass. Yay. Phantom lens. All right, put you back in there. We just need to make the mana spreader now. We were gonna make an elven one, so I need to see what I have for Dreamwood upstairs and Elementium. I have some there, but do I have any in here? I do. One Elementium, and do I need a petal for this one? I think this might be our first elven spreader. Oh, this one needs... Hang on. I mean, we still need one, but I'm ahead of myself in my list. So yeah, we need one for thermally output. We need a mana pool. Hourglass. Getting there, guys. I need more living rock. I have some in here, but this stuff I creative cheated in because it's for building purposes. And so I can't pull this stuff out to use for progress, like what we're doing right now. Would be too cheaty for me. Thanks. Living wood, open crates. We don't need the abstruse platform or the patterned. I need to eat on my some potatoes soon. Okay. Mana pool. Hourglass with 6 soul sand. So I need, I was in here for something and I don't think I have it in here. I need more mana glass and I need mana steel. All right. Great. Going up and down a lot. My apologies. This is probably what everyone does when they've got Let's Plays that they're doing. This is the stuff you don't see. Hourglass. We need 6 soul sand. We can do filler blocks. That's not a problem. Need a bunch of buckets. Oh, we need a hopper hawk and item, 2 item frames. Leather, and I've got enough sticks for the item frames. Hopper hawk we need to craft. I'm running out of space in my inventory for all this stuff. And all the buckets, which we are going to painfully have to come up with. Not currently, but yeah. So. There we go. And we're going to need to make the obsidian. So we need to do blaze mesh because we're going to need another portal over there. And probably build another one in the nether if it connects to our existing one because we don't want it to connect. We have that to do also. Let's get this stuff placed over there and go from there. The nether portal probably needs to be built. So let's first figure out where the nether portal is going in the middle of this platform. We can use this dirt, so I'm not worried. But I need to figure out where things intersect. Loop. Right there. All right. So that's where I'm going to want the nether portal. Okay. And then I didn't do any counting about where this stuff is going to be, and I don't have any building blocks on me either. I wanted to build the one furthest out first. The Ranocarpus was how, what the range of the Ranocarpus was again? 17? 17. So if we decide that the Ranocarpus is going to go, we'll say right here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Oh, that's right. Yeah. That would put we're doing cheaty cheaty things. Might as well really do cheaty cheaty things. I don't want to do this one, but we're gonna get a diluted pool. And a tablet and fill it up. Okay. Great. Thanks. Gimme. All right. Now we can actually see the range of it so we don't screw this up. Yeah. So the first flower is going to go there. Do we want to push it back then? Or are we okay with it if we put another... This is already too big here, but we might be happier with it pushed back. To there. Yeah. Dang it. I didn't bring ladder material. 12 sticks, that might be enough. Three, I doubt it. So that's a bit better. The first one will go here. That's the first flower. And so the dispenser goes there. And then the second flower will go here, but we're doing this one because that's the unit. And then the piston will go here. We'll have to do that from underneath. And then we need hopper hocks. Back here. Which we can't really place until that. Go down there. That's not where this goes. All right. We get it. We have to move those. Where these goes. That's where the lava's gonna end up. La la la. Okay. That's what I get for not going off of a picture. And we obviously need to go further out here. But the world shaper does a sphere. Nope. And then there we go. And sure, we have dirt, which we'll need to put a empty bucket in here. I think we have to have a certain amount of dirt, but that might be enough just to close off those so that the bucket always falls here. I think. Let's put a torch up here so that we don't kill ourselves. Yeah, we will have to expand this so that I can put... I don't like being on the very edge here. And we need building blocks. And do we want the mana to shoot that way? Or do we want it to shoot this way? That's our other thought. Okay. That we'll get rid of when I make one of my own. This is the cheated in one. We know it's cheated in. It's just to help us know where the range is of the Renegarpus. That's it. The Hopper Hawk is bigger. So I'm not worried about that. It'll be in the similar vicinity there, but it's large enough that it'll reach the block underneath this open crate, and that's as far as it'll need to go for the diagonal reach. So we need another space over here, but we're gonna need to do when I'm not looking at it in creative, my mind is like, what were you doing? Hopper Hawks, we need two of them. But I don't want to place them until I've got a mana pool in range of it. Because otherwise it won't pick up the buckets from the portal. What is the range of the Hopper Hawk without power? Hopper Hawk without power, 13. I think we need... Let's grab one. Because because it'll go the furthest one here. For Floromancer Season 3, you want another base. That's not big enough. Yeah, we're going to need to make sure that before we, that when we place, we're going to either need to make a Floral Obedience stick or, not place them until we have mana. I'm going to get rid of you. Loop. All right. I feel really out of it today. I was much more in tune with what I wanted to do yesterday. We need to do some blaze mesh to make another portal. And we need the supplies to do the bucket throwing. Means another hopper hawk. Do we have a dropper in here? No, we do have a comparator. Oh, here's an earthen repeater. This is what we got. I can't remember who it was. I'm not sure if they're here today. But we got our first earthen part. No, these are dispensers. So we need a dropper. We need some building blocks. Piece of redstone, a chest, and building blocks. I need to grab some wood to make a chest. Goodness. I can't wait for more automated stuff. Yeah, it'd be a lot of bucket runs, and I don't feel like doing that. Yeah, I mean, I could. You make a point. You make a point. I have to make a lot of buckets for the thermal lilies. I have to make 20 just for the two thermal lilies that we're trying to set up. Yeah. So little iron, you're not wrong. I definitely need iron. I think this might be right about all we have. Yeah. Oh, powered rail. So, dropper, comparator, powered rail, some redstone, a hopper, a chest, and then the hopper hawk that we have to make. Oh, and an item frame. We need to do another item frame. I think I can do that. And then our next concern is that I'm probably out of charcoal in my endoflames. Because I didn't have a ton. Yep. So I'm just losing time here. quite painful. Just know that they're just sitting there ticking away. Tick, tick. Of course. I would love to have the mod that spreads things evenly. I did some calculations. I don't remember if I did it with you guys or not, about charcoal blocks versus charcoal pieces. We did figure out it was more efficient to use blocks in that you get more time out of them compared to the same amount of charcoal. So we had figured out that we needed 90 something charcoal per hour per flower, something like that. Let's see. Yeah, I don't remember where that was written down, but I have charcoal takes, this is in vanilla, 80 seconds in a furnace, which means on an endo flame it'll take 40 seconds. And a block of charcoal takes 800 seconds to burn, so it'll take 400 seconds in an endo flame, which means we need 20 blocks of charcoal instead of 90-something pieces per hour per flower, which means 15 stacks of charcoal blocks per pad. That's, we've got four pads there, only one's working, per hour. I need to be producing 15 stacks of charcoal blocks an hour in order to run that one pad consistently. Currently, not doing it. So that's something to consider. Yeah. Anima asked, do you have a plan of when you're going into the end? I heard something yesterday, wasn't sure if it was in the right context. Going to automate all pre-Alfheim flowers first, then post-Alfheim and act? No. I just plan on getting some of the, just want to do pre-Alfheim generating flowers first before I get into the post-Alfheim ones. It's not attached to the end at all. The sticking point for me right now is that I need to kill the Gaia a few times before I can get to the end. And for that, I would like Terra Steel, and we're not really producing enough. I'd need to turn everything off to try to bulk up on mana to make a bunch of Terra Steel, unless I do Elementium the first time, which I would only need iron. A lot of it, but I would only need iron. And I don't have decent gear as far as tools that I want, and I don't have the beacon, so I need to kill a wither, and I don't have the blocks to make the beacon, the 9 iron or whatever. I don't have the platform built, but I need to kill the Gaia several times before I can go to the end. So that's kind of where I'm kicking my heels. Did that answer it for you? Yeah. It's not as easy like in some tech packs where you've got a end cake. Yeah. The end portal blocks. I think I've shown them before. The end portal blocks are this recipe. And of course, we need 12 of them. So we need 24 Gaia Spirits. Gaia Spirits We can get like 3 to 4, perhaps, I think, with Gaia 1. I think. So, yeah, that's where we're at. I know where I'm going to put the portal. It's going to live under here, under these stairs. It will fit perfectly here. But yeah. So, making obsidian. Do I want to run back and forth numerous times to the Nether? Because I'm not making 10 buckets right now. I don't think I have enough. I do, but that'd be consuming a lot. I guess we would need the lava anyway. Brr, That's where I'm at with things. Yep. Let's do that. Let's go to the end, or let's go to the Nether, get a bunch of lava so I don't have to kill a bunch of blazes. Good news is they stack in this pack. We'll do 12. Yep, I can use them in the Thermalily gen anyway. You're correct. Yeah. We need to put you back. All right. Oh. Well, that was unfun. Woot. I haven't made this a safe trip simply because this isn't going to be our main direction for getting lava, so I haven't figured out what I was going to do yet. That stinks. Moving animals around is always a pain. Always a pain. Water. Actually, I think we still have our water source, our initial water source. Might as well give it a go. I'd like to check something. It's been an hour plus. Did it place the flower where it will actually be useful? No. It hasn't placed it yet. Or if it did, I'm concerned that it placed it down here somewhere. not sure. Oh, that would be, yep, that the first pulse went into the hopper. There's my problem. So now we don't know. Yep, we have our original water. I don't think I have anything underneath those blocks. And now this fun process begins. So what is everyone doing today? I think we've done the sheep eating grass watching too. Yeah, pretty much. There are things that skyblocks tend to force you to do that you don't have to do in world generally. So I think it's time to tear down our old mob farm. We were a net gain of ender pearls, which makes me feel good from this. So we can tear this down. It's slowing down the rates of this one anyway because there are mobs in there. So if we tear it down, just decided I already had water here, so there was no reason to use my water wand. No reason whatsoever. But, of course, the standing here. Moms are moving around here, too. Or 14. We only got 12 buckets, so I guess we're doing 10. No corners. Etho would be not happy. Let's grab that XP. Anyone watch any good TV lately? I'm always on the lookout for series and movies that are entertaining that I don't have to pay attention super deeply. True, I could have made the portal there that way. You're right, Darkwing. Was not even on my mind to create the obsidian in the portal shape. Of course it's gonna rain, because raining's what I like. Raining is great fun. Now we need to do this. Don't watch TV. Nothing from you. Okey-dokey. And this will be empty buckets. So the next thing we need to do, three hopper hawks and a random carpus and then we need to do the nether side, which the nether side will just be another one of these sort of deals. And this thing that we made in the creative with the actual dispenser pickup stuff. So the bigger deal. I wonder if we can join the two. So it's one setup that does two things. I guess it's worth looking into. We're mostly all set here. We just have to do hopper hawks. Oh, and I need to do in creative. I need to expand this one or two more and get the mana detectors on top and wherever the mana spreader is going to be. Probably from down there. Shoot this way. How many do we figure were this way? 10? I don't remember. Let's go look again, look at our test world again. Of course, I could just activate the hop rock and see where the range ends. Like really. 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah. You're thinking about fighting the Wither just to get the Builder's Wand. Yeah. Oh. That's probably why it doesn't get any of the man into the pool. Look. It stops there being efficient. The rest of these aren't as efficient. I mean, I suppose that could be like hopper potency? Not hopper, phantom potency. I think potency is the one that has more mana per pulse. Would a mana prism help? Perhaps. So you're thinking like if I did a potency velocity on, maybe not velocity, but a potency something lens on the spreader and then phantom on the prism? I mean, it's not bad. I mean, it clearly has enough mana to get to the end. So I don't think I need to extend it further. It might help. It might. Yeah, so let's just go back to the other world. Okay, well, before I do that, what I was thinking about with this setup combined with the other one is, can we do this setup in the Nether where this is up against the lava lake? So this will be safe for us to be over on this side. That'll be the lava lake side. But this is the filled up with lava water chest. If we can put a hopper underneath this and not have that, I don't think that would interact. We put a hopper under here and point it into the dropper that's going into the Nether portal. Hi, Hermes. Where would we put the redstone so that it wouldn't interact with that? That's the problem. I know this is a dispenser and not a dropper. We would need to... Ooh, I wonder if we could. I do not have a... There's a comparator. Of course, because excuse me, Hermes, you're in my way, sweet boy. Down you go, sweetheart. Stuck. That's why you're stuck. You're a trapped chest. I just want to know if we could do this. I'm pretty sure we can, but I like to see it. Make it happen. Where did my... So much stuff in my inventory, and it of course deleted what I wanted there. Why? Why? What is different? I have no idea. I really don't. Anyone? They look exactly the same, and this one works just fine. I hope I don't have this problem in my main playthrough. The only thing that's what I can see is different is it's pointing a different direction. But it's the same direction as this one, and this one works. So why is it maintaining a signal? I get rid of you. That's still lit up because of these. We take them out. There's nothing in there right now. I don't know. Don't know. Seriously. I'm so confused. I am really tired of this. Let's start over. Dropper. Comparator. Blocks. Powered rail. Why am I doing this when I can just do... that. Huh. So it has to do one at a time. That makes sense because otherwise it keeps a consistent comparator signal. Why does this work? Does the hopper hawk into the chest only do one at a time? Yeah, this is just going to keep going and going, by the way, because the Hopper Hawk is just going to keep picking them up. All right, so what the problem was is there was already a bunch of them in there, but as long as the hopper just moves one in at a time, we should be fine. Hello, Golden Lion. Oh. So I'm wondering. Pretend this is lava because this will work with lava too. I think it might work. Current project is thermal lilies. This is the collecting the lava in the nether and then sending it into the portal, which will be right here. We do have the problem that once this fills up, though. So that could be our setup. Now, this portal, we can point the portal here. We'll probably put it here, though, because if this is lava over here, because I don't know where the lake's going to be, but the lava lake level. If that's lava, we'll probably want to put the portal on this side. We'll figure it out though. But there's our lava bucket system, which then the lava buckets will come through this portal and be picked up by all of our hopper hawks in our for to fill our dispensers to run the system. Yes, I suppose so. I would have to then send mana to the overworld. either way, I have to send something through the portal, whether that be the buckets or the mana that is being produced. My thought is it's a much smaller setup to do the bucket filling in the Nether and do the farm in the overworld. One, I have less issues with zombies, skellies, pig ghasts, whatnot, having to deal with that. So, yeah. Alright. Good to know that this will work. This is modified Il Mango design to use Batania instead of a dropper elevator, is what he used in his setup. Used a dropper elevator right here to fill this chest. And I just used an open crate and a hopper hawk instead. Yep, the hopper hawks will pick up buckets of lava in the overworld and place them in the dispenser. Much like the buckets are being done into these chests here. Dispensers are considered an inventory, so it will fill them. It does mean I need 9 buckets of lava per dispenser. So it's going to get expensive. Thus, why I'm making all of my setups be expandable over time, as I have resources to make them bigger. Yeah. Ooh, this is all fully grown. Should we trigger it again just for the funs? Just for funsies? The bottom layer should be fully grown too. Yeah. I am not showing any dropped frames whatsoever. I'm on fiber. So it'd be really amazing if I were having problems. I've got 1 gig symmetrical. Let's push the button! Yeah, so awesome. I can't wait to have this running. Really, really, really can't. Can't wait. Why aren't you guys being picked up? Oh, I know why. Never mind. Seeing the old textures after playing 116. Yeah, I can imagine. I can imagine. We'll likely be playing this for another year with how slow I'm going. So, yeah. For comparison's sake, the Thermalily setup episodes on my previous season were episodes 15, 16, and 17. And we're at, when I look at YouTube, we're in the 40s already. We're a little slower here. Not a bad thing, because we're doing a lot of creative, massive building. Are there any 116 packs interest you? Yes, the Direwolf 20 pack does interest me. I just do not have time to do more than one pack at a time. I just don't have the extra time to do that. And it would irritate me to only spend 1 stream a week doing each pack. I would be irritated, so... the circular force relay is a tree farm. I have it turned off right now, but it's a birch tree farm. Birch trees. I probably just need to throw some saplings down and get the... Yeah. Is the main thing holding you back the no need for automating generating flower making? No, not at all. You saying holding me back from playing a 116 pack? No. I spent several months not wanting to play Minecraft, and I didn't stream for several months. I'm not sure if you guys remember that, but quite a bit of 2020 I didn't stream. And it was mainly because none of the packs that I saw, because that was before Direwolf 20 came out, I wanted to play. I was just like, I don't really want to play any of these. But I loaded up Floramancer on my own just to kind of poke at, and I'm like, this I'm having lots of fun with. This, I want to do this again. And so it just came to the point of, if I want to play Minecraft and I want to stream, play stuff you want to play. And I wanted to play this again. That's it. And since I'm not playing to grow my channel or increase YouTube subscribers or anything, it's not a job for me. It's not even a part-time thing. I play what I want to play, and you guys seem to enjoy watching me struggle with Floramancer. So. All right. All right, so we've got this set up. We needed to make the hopper hawks, right? And we were just trying to figure out the nether side of things before. Did I take pictures of that, I wonder? To go, because we need more obsidian, and we're gonna need to do the mining of it because I need to do it in the nether. No. I'm not a programmer, and so understanding programming logic doesn't come very easy to me. I have used PHP to make websites, but the code in those was terrible. That was years ago, and to have to learn Lua doesn't really interest me at all. How are we doing? Well, at least we're running. But see, here's our problem. This is gonna probably fill up before it empties. And we're backlogging mana that shouldn't sit here. I watch Edward code. It seems kind of odd to say, but I have sat and watched. That's the, Ed does the coding. He loves the coding. And even he doesn't like computer craft, really. He's like, if I want to code, I'll do that for work. I don't want to code for gameplay. Makes sense, I guess. Oh, goodness. Well, let's do the first thing I want to do. Let's activate that portal, see where it ends up, because we're likely going to need to move it. You know, he does it as a hobby too. It's just that it's not during gaming that he wants to do it. Because he codes constantly almost. He's coding for his work, and then he's coding for my work, because he's the programmer behind the stuff that I do. And then he also codes for fun. And I'm doing air quotes fun because to me it doesn't seem like fun. Because I think what he's doing right now is like learning about font repositories and how to list all of the metadata of fonts and how to organize them and label. It's beyond me. Beyond. And he also does hobby coding with the idea of a automated home, so turning lights on and off, making sure the thermostats are set the way you want them to, opening the garage when you approach, that sort of stuff. He loves the idea of having an automated home as well. No idea. I don't know if that's true or not, if firing mana into a spreader loses mana. Probably. If the mana spreader is full, probably. Which is why I need to rework that setup. I mentioned at the beginning of my stream and you probably missed it. I need to rework the way that's functioning because it's really janky. So yeah, I'm probably losing a decent amount of mana for the way it is right now. All right, this is a relatively far way from our portal that's over there on the mainland. So I'm hoping this generates a new portal. It did not. All right, so we will need to tie it up in with dimension with the blah blah blah. We'll need it coordinates. Yeah, I'll have to make another portal and move it. Anyway, guess what time it is, guys? Hello, you two. Three. Oh, they're all here. Exactly. Time to feed the kitties. And unfortunately, I think I'm going to end it for today. I'm running out of steam. A lot of things to figure out. Boy, Heimdall's really hungry. He's making circles. Spinning in circles. Okay. Thanks for watching, folks. I'm going to go now. Take care. Have a great rest of your day. Bye.